Hi, I'm Floris. Today we're gonna walk you through the process of setting up our drone solution for automated inspections. There are a couple of steps involved in here, so we want to guide you through this process and make it as smooth as possible. So I'd say let's jump right in. First, we have here the case with the drone itself. Remote controller is also attached to it. We have our own payload in there, which we need to attach to the drone later on, as well as the batteries to power everything. First, the drone itself. In this case, you can find the drone, the remote controller, the landing legs, which we're going to attach to the drone soon, as well as the camera payload. First of all, it's important to first put the legs on there whilst it's still in the case. It makes it easier to finally turn it out and put it on the ground. With these legs, it's important to note the red markings. Put them in like so and turn the little securing cap, once it's in place, half a turn until these marks align. Similarly, can be done for the other leg, taking into account the markings and twisting it half a turn again. Now that this process is done, we can remove the drone from the case and put it on a steady surface to work on further. So with the drone removed now from the case, we can attach our computer, the brains of the drone. We can attach the LiDAR with which the drone sees the sensor, sees its environment, as well as the camera, so the sensor with which we're gonna take the inspection photos. First of all, the computer. Let's move over to our case. In here, you can find the LiDAR sensor as well as the computer, which we're gonna mount first. These rails will guide this computer through here, and after you've heard the click, you know it's securely mounted in place. An extra security measure, very important, is this cotter pin, which we can place behind here in order to ensure that even if this might fail, it doesn't come loose. What we can do next is attach the sensor, the LiDAR sensor we talked about before, remove the securing cap to show the mount, as well as on the gimbal. So with the sensor, we can attach it like so, with the white mark aligning with the red mark, twisting it for 45 degrees until the red marks align and you hear a click, so that you know it's secured in place. The other part of the payload, the camera, we can also attach at this stage, removing the securing cap. And removing the other protective cap from here as well. Again, important to align the white and the red dots together, twist it for 45 degrees until the red marks align and you hear the click. For the camera, it's also important to remove the cover to prevent having no images whatsoever. This computer module can be attached to the drone itself, so that communication is possible, and as well as power, as well as to the sensor. For this, we have two extra cables in this case, which we're gonna attach now. There's a short cable for the computer and a longer cable for the LiDAR sensor, where first there's a protective cap here on the drone, which we can remove, and then plug in the cable. There's only one way to plug it in, so it's important not to force it, but feel that it goes in smoothly. Then there's another securing connector on here, which we need to twist until tightened, until you can turn it no more and the red ring is not visible anymore. Then we know it's securely in place. Similarly, it's the case for the LiDAR sensor. You need to attach one part of it to the sensor itself and twist it until you hear a click, but don't overdo it. Routing the cable through here, behind the leg, until it's, again, it's a similar connector, twist in place on the drone, and you cannot see the red ring here anymore. Now we can remove or move out the arms of the drone, removing a small piece of protective foam, which protects the propellers on either side. And fold out the arms in the order of the lower arm first, which moves under the upper arm. And similarly then the upper arm with two securing clamps tightening the drone. We move these over in its position and twist it until these two red marks align. Similarly for the other side, until these red marks align. Moving over, you do the similar feat here, the lower arm first, which moves out all of the way, and then the upper arm, securing the arms in place with the corresponding clamps until the marks align. With this setup like this, of course the drone does not have any power. For this, we need to place one pair of batteries, so two batteries, into the battery compartment. These batteries are supplied in a specific case, additional case, which also allows for charging these batteries, where one pair can be obtained like so, and placed with the correct, with the connectors facing the correct way into the drone, like so. Then it's important to actually tighten this security handle and secure these batteries in place. You cannot untighten it easily. You need to press these two buttons in order for it to be released then again. But for the flight, it's important to have this in the closed position, securing the batteries in place. So this concludes the assembly of the hardware on the drone. The next step would be to prepare the remote controller, attach an iPad to it so that you can easily start the inspection from there.